rely on exports for 85% of our pulse production here in Canada. So unimpeded market access for us means the ability to supply the pulses that hungry global markets need. One of our key result areas is market access, and there's really two components to that. That's ensuring that we have access to international markets and ensuring that our transportation system is functioning at the highest level possible. Well, given that we're highly dependent on just a handful of markets for most of our movement, if we lose access to any one of those markets, it can result in significant reductions in prices for farmers, as well as slowdowns in movement from the farm to port position.
In Europe, pulses have already had duty-free access, but the issue is what we call tariff escalation. This means that you have access for your whole product, but if you want to process a product domestically, then send your processed product, you face higher tariff barriers. Under CETA, we will now have duty-free access for processed pulse products as well as for whole pulses. And Canada has been first in line securing this trade agreement. The key area of technology use that the Canadian pulse industry is focusing on is MRLs, or maximum residue limits. This is a concern when products that are legally registered for growers to use in Canada may not have tolerances established in all importing countries.
Growers need to pay particular attention to all of the label recommendations that come with various crop protection products we use on our farms. They need to pay attention to the rates they're using, to the timeliness of application, to the crop stage relative to the time of application, and ensure they're doing it in a way that is in alignment with what the label requires.
As part of the keepingitclean.ca process, we put together a value chain team of experts consisting of trade people, agronomists, exporters, and others, and ultimately come up with a list of recommendations. The entire information package can be accessed at keepingitclean.ca.
So one of the things that Pulse Canada works on along with government is to make sure that we have a variety of different markets around the world to go to and to increase our access to those markets. One of the major things we need to be able to capitalize on that work is to have a well-functioning transportation system. Our largest focus is to make sure that at those times of year or any time of year when we have sales programs to try and get crop overseas, that the capacity is there in the transportation system so that when a grower harvests their crop, they can get it to market immediately and get the cash flow.
Both market access and transportation are really important to growers. It's one thing to open a market and have sales made to a particular market in the world, but we as growers need to get that product to ocean ports quickly, efficiently, and in a cost-effective manner in order to compete on a world scale with other suppliers around the world.
What we've done is we've partnered with a variety of other commodity organizations, and we formed what's called the Ag Transport Coalition. So we put a lot of effort into making sure we have performance metrics in place for the railways that look at how much they're supplying cars to meet the grain industry's demand and whether they're doing it in a timely way. The second thing we look at is what we call a building capacity within the supply chain. There's a variety of regulations and legislation that are governing the system, governing the interactions between the railways and the shippers, and they can be confusing.
Grower access to international markets is a core element of productivity, and that's why we work nationally with other grower groups, as well as the industry, to deliver results on market access and transportation for farmers. For more information on market access and transportation, visit saspulse.com.